so, my friends. Swimmer and lovers, this is just for you. You know, today, we all will be witnessing a doping cheating right at the swimming pool. Right in front of us, right on our eyes, we all can see it. When athletes will come to the swimming deck, they will be wearing their rob coats, and some of them may wear earphones. They will be listening to music, but this music, as research says, is an artificial increase of the blood oxygen capacity. This is an artificial performance enhancement, which is prohibited by World Anti-Doping Association. It says the following words: enhancements of oxygen transfer is prohibited. The following are prohibited: artificially enhancing the uptake, transport, or delivery of oxygen. And there are a number of research showing that this is exactly the case. I'll give you the facts. First, you see, Dr. Kirsch from Germany says that music can enhance oxygen capacity of blood by two mechanisms. One is the effect on breathing rate, and another one is the relaxation effect when fewer muscles consume oxygen, and this increases the oxygen capacity of blood locally for those muscles that do their job while the athlete is swimming. There is another researcher, Luciano Bernardi from University of Pavia, Italy, who is saying that the withdrawal of music shortly before the swim race inducing relaxing effects, which is noted also by Dr. Kirsch. It's quite clear that music can reduce the effort associated with a given physical load, say another two scientists from Karolinska Institute in Sweden. Music reduces the effort associated with a given physical load, they state, because the body is better, has a better ability to coordinate muscles and economize the use of energy. Moreover, this effect is likely can be programmed, and this goes together with the testimony of the coach of Michael Phelps. In his interview to American newspaper Washington Post, I watched it at the YouTube, this video, you can see it yourself. The interview is called like the psychology of speed. But it would be psychology, unless it is a doping, by listening to music at the swimming pool deck a minute before the competition. So, another evidence comes from the research done in human infants, but they allow a great standardization of the protocol, of the research protocol, which will be hard to achieve in swimmers. And I have another evidence from testimony of the scientist who says that experimentation with infants allows good standardization of the research protocol, appropriate statistic, and could be projected to adults. But what research in infants showed that music causes better saturation of hemoglobin with oxygen, indicating clearly an enhancement of oxygen transfer. And that increase by music oxygen saturation returns to the baseline quite fast, making it hard to detect shortly thereafter. You see the point? You do doping, you do the swim, being in much better position than other athletes, and then you are clean. You are not clean, you are a cheater. Watch it yourself today, tonight, at the Olympic swimming pool in London. So, can one call listening to music shortly before entering the swimming pool for competition a performance enhancement? Yes, say two group of scientists. It's in line with this at the third group of scientists. But how lasts the effect long? How long the effect lasts? Duration is not certain, from seconds to minutes. But this is in agreement with the short swimming period for world records and Olympic medals. Another scientist said that this is a performance enhancement, and it's a biochemical feedback mechanism for an external effect, for an external source. And the external source is the ejection through the sonic syringe. with the purpose to increase the blood oxygen's capacity. But the scientist says that he is not sure how it's related to the WADA regulations. But you see, WADA regulations are straightforward. Enhancement of oxygen transfer is prohibited. Artificially enhancing the uptake, transport and delivery of oxygen is strictly prohibited. So, watch tonight for London 2012 Olympic Games and witness yourself how swimmers do cheating right at the pool deck, a minute or two before the competition. Watch it yourself, report it in the comments, and write a complaint to organizers using the information provided in the description of this video. Do your research yourself. Be a responsible anti-doping citizen. It's easy and it's within your capacity. Once others, officials, cannot do it, do it yourself. You can. You must. Don't let the cheaters become the gold holders.